33 years ago, this was released to the public, and it changed the gaming industry as we know it. Welcome to the channel, everybody. Something a little different. Jimmy, your Chaos here. I thought I would bring you into my world of collecting just a little bit. If you didn't know, I have started collecting vintage retro games, consoles, anything that is in the gaming industry because it directly ties to me. I've been playing video games since I was 4 years old. So things like this, it just plays on my nostalgic heartstrings like crazy. And I thought it would be cool to do an unboxing for you guys. So if you enjoy this type of thing, you want to see more things unboxed or from my collection, maybe the Super NES complete inbox console I have, let me know. Drop a like, leave me a comment. Let me know if you enjoy this type of content. Now I'm just learning when it comes to CIB, what's good, what's bad, what you're looking for, what you don't want to have. I am new to retro gaming collection. So if you have thoughts, if you have comments, if you want to tell me what you're after, definitely, definitely do. You can join my Discord, Team Chaos Discord, where I'm going to start talking about it as well. Now, I don't have the perfect setup for this. I don't have an eagle eye view, so I've got the camera on wide, and once we get it open, maybe we'll zoom in and look at some stuff. This is the Nintendo Action Set with the orange light gun. Now, there was a gray version as well. This one comes with Duck Hunt and Mario, two controllers and your zapper, and it's pretty cool. Now, I got this off of eBay, and it is in really, really good shape. Complete in box, everything. We're gonna go over everything. They even sent all the paperwork in a separate box, and there is the game. So we're gonna unbox this, take a look, dive into gaming history, if you will. This has me super excited. I'm smiling. But let's get started. So obviously, we have the Mario Bro and Duck Hunt. The two-game pack, which came with the original NES dust sleeve. It's got some stuff on it. I don't know. You don't expect everything to be perfect. You just hope for the best you can get when it comes to this. And then we have all the paperwork that goes with the system. This is what you would have received. Let's be careful here. If you would have bought this 33 years ago, look at this. Back when manuals were a thing. I absolutely loved. This is the official seal. Hopefully I'm getting this on here where you guys can see it. Now the manuals very quickly became color, but this is going to teach you the bulldozer attack, the chain reactions, everything you need to know to connect it, but also about the game. It would actually teach you how to play the game. This manual is in fantastic shape. We're gonna set that over there. We've got the poster, which I'm not going to undo, the Nintendo Power poster. You guys can see it. It's in really good shape too. The artwork is great. Once again, 33 years old, which is crazy. We got a business reply, Nintendo of America, Washington, Attention Consumer Department. Oh, we have a 90-day warranty on our NES. We can put our name, we can put our address, our date of birth, where we bought it from. And we will have a 90-day warranty on our NES, which is pretty cool. The control deck tells you all about the actual console. Once again, this is all black and white. They would go color, I say pretty fast, after they got going. But these are in really, really good shape, which is great. And the final piece of paperwork is your zapper. A whole different caliber, haha, of entertainment. We're gonna talk about the zapper. There's a way to know if the zapper's real or not. All right, there's our paperwork. Now, the actual box. This is big. This is the original box. Everything is in it. And I don't know if you guys can see this. I'm gonna try, actually, once I get the, well, here. Check it out. Thank you for shopping at Woolworth. Woolworth was a department store, kind of like a Target, and it went out of business in 1997. Now, I don't know when this one was purchased, but this sticker kind of adds flair and nostalgia to it. Even more so, look at the Woolworth price tag, $119. I'm obviously going to leave all that on there. I'm gonna turn it around for you guys. I'm not doing any cuts or anything. Like I said, I'm not really set up for this, but we'll make it work. There's the back. action-packed excitement for the entire family. You get the control deck, you get the two controllers, you get the games, you get the zapper, the light gun. The artwork is absolutely fantastic. This box is in really, really good shape. So now I may cut away because I'm going to attempt to get this out of here. This one has the styrofoam and all. I'll try it on camera, but I don't want to mess up the box or mess anything up. We're going to slide it out. Probably nothing satisfying about that sound. There we go. The box is just as important as the system. Actually, the box is more important than the system. And a lot of people probably say, don't open it, don't mess with it. Well, I'm being careful, but the whole point of this is to share it with you guys and share it with myself, to be honest with you. All right, we've got the box. We'll set the box right there. And then we have the styrofoam. So when you're getting anything retro vintage, you want every piece of it. You want everything that would bring you back to the experience of going and buying this action set and unboxing it as a kid. The styrofoam was huge. This was a big part of it. So having the actual complete authentic styrofoam is a big deal. All right, guys, we're gonna open this and see what's in it. Hopefully you guys are okay with the wide angle. Like I said, it's the only way we're gonna get everything on here. I know it's not normal viewing, but I want you guys to be able to see everything. Styrofoam coming off, you're a kid, and you open this, and you freak out because you are about to be gaming. This is the original NES. You can see the coloring just due to 33 years. This is actually light gray, but I'm sure air got to it, and it kind of browns out, if you will, which is fine. That just adds to the flavor, if you ask me. So let's start with the controllers. You would receive two controllers, and these are OEM authentic controllers to this. Now, I haven't tried to match serial numbers or anything. I haven't messed with that. Maybe I will. But this is where it all started. We got a little white speck there. I don't know if that'll come off or not. Buttons work. D-pads don't feel sticky. So we'll stick that back in there. We'll check out the other controller real quick. Same thing, you're looking for the D-pad to work and the buttons not to be sticky. And it's all got the same color hue to it. It's kind of like if you collect coins. This would be the equivalent of patina, if you would, on a coin. So the more age natural patina a coin gets, the more valuable it is. It's a good thing. You want naturally aged patina, and I'm hoping it's the same with this. I could be wrong, but I don't know. Then you've got your battery. You've got the infamous hookup. Gosh, so many times having to find one of these or making sure the TV and everything worked right there. That is definitely super old. Now, let's talk about the orange zapper, the light gun. These things have a very distinctive sound when you pull the trigger. Model number NES-005, made in Japan, patent pending. I wonder if they ever got the patent. 1985, guys. All right, so listen really closely. Every NES zapper I've ever touched has that same ping to it. Now, I don't know if that's a way to tell it's not a knockoff or what, but they have a very, very distinctive sound. Now, there is a gray version of this. I don't know which one is worth more. I don't know if the orange is more sought after or the gray. If you know, you can let me know in the comment section. And finally, the biggest piece of it all. What you would actually play. Let's see if I can get this fully in here. We got some styrofoam. I'll get it out in a minute. The actual console. There it is. No game stuck in it. You would put your game cartridge, which is right here. Actually, why not, right? Let's do it. We get the NES. We get it hooked up. We want to play some Mario. We put it in. We try to put it in. There we go. Almost there. And it's in. Power it up. Red light comes on. Hopefully the red light's not blinking. If it is, you're probably gonna blow in your cartridge and try to make sure I do this right. I don't wanna mess it up. You're probably gonna blow in your cartridge and try to get it to work. It may not, even though blowing in the cartridge really didn't do anything for you. You've got controller port 1, 2, power, reset. You never wanted to hit that reset button if you weren't playing a game that was saved. Audio, video, AC adapter for your power, 2 channels, and your AF switch. And that was it. You hooked all that up, and you were gaming. Absolutely classic. There you have it, guys. That is my Nintendo NES action set complete in box. I have a Super NES one if you guys want to do an unboxing and go through that one as well. My plan is to get every console ever made complete in box with all the original stuff that I can for my collection. Let me know if you guys enjoy this type of content, if you enjoyed seeing this unboxed, and I'll see you guys soon.